Hello and welcome to our channel. I'm Anna Marie and today I've got a lovely tutorial for you using a lot of lovely products and I will be making a birthday card. Now, first of all, I will show you the products that I will be using and that is bloom flower dye, flower leaves, they come in two, a pack of two, then flower sprigs. I will also use a circle bloom die stamp set and also few tags from a Garden Bloom Blue collection of tags and postcards. And some, well, in fact, one sheet only from the 12 by 12 Garden Bloom collection of paper pads. Now, the one sheet, one design that I will be using, it's this one, wood grain effect in white. And the reason why I'm using it in from the 12 by 12, because the 12 by 12 size has got every design bigger than the sizes below, 8 by 8, 7 by 7, 6 by 6, so on. Okay, now, few other things, really. This product is called Vine Silk. And it's beautiful. There's, I think, about 8 pieces of that in the pack. And they are so delicate, so I will be just chopping them up and adding them into my arrangement. Okay, and also a little bit of a sort of string, very delicate string for the center of my flower. And also tulle. Now, before I actually proceed with my card, I will actually color my tulle using the Inca silk waxes, which I've turned into the spray. So these are pearlescent sprays and they're literally going to color everything, okay, for me. So the tulle is very delicate, but all I want is just a little bit of a touch, okay, added to my card. So I'm gonna spray this all over and leave it to dry. Now, if you want to see how I turn my Inca Gold waxes into sprays, then you can see our other tutorials on here on our channel. I'm also going to spray very, very quickly and very gently, just a leaf and a sprig. And I'm gonna put it to the side to dry everything. Now, before I start my demo, okay, I also like to, well, introduce everyone to our brand new little feature, okay? Now, if you would like to learn more about this feature, please stay tuned. And obviously I will mention that towards the end of the video. Okay, so now I have my piece, my wood grain effect from the 12 by 12 already cut to size. And what I am going to do first, it's actually using just a pair of scissors. I'm going to cut it into small pieces, ink up the edges, rough up the edges, and I'm going to stick them onto my base card. So what I'm doing now is basically cutting up my 3D pad into long strip and placing my strips in the middle of my, well, wood grain strips, okay? You will see why, because what I want to create is actually a curved sides to my strip. So they're not going to be straight. They're going to be slightly going into, you know, into the base of my mount. Well, that's the aim anyway. So I've got my strip here and the last one here. So every piece has got a 3D pad. Okay, now we're just gonna reverse it and plan it for the card. Like I said, the pad is in the middle, but all I am going to do, I'm actually going to mold it slightly like so. Okay, so they're not straight. Each piece exactly the same way. So my strips are applied onto my base card, and by the way, this base card is our A5 scalloped card blank, and it's amazing. So you've got scalloped on both sides. I really love working on these cards. Now, so what I am going to do, I'm going to take two of the tags out of my garden bloom tags and postcards out, okay, and they're going to be in the background, giving me a little bit of a floral look. Now we can also rough up the edges, but just quickly and just a little bit. And then I'm gonna show you obviously what I'm gonna do next using the stamp, just actually on two sides because I don't need it all over. Now, if you remember, I had a strip of tulle covered, okay, with the ink gold wax spray in blue. And obviously normally that's just see-through white piece. But can you see all I am getting now? I hope you can see it, but I'm getting this beautiful blue tint. If I wanted to have my tulle darker, then I would spray a little bit more. And but for this card, I'm actually going to leave it as it is. All I am going to do, it's actually trim it a little bit. Okay, and that would be absolutely fine. Right, okay, so I'm getting everything ready. And the final thing is using the stamps. Okay, so I already have two circles that I've stamped and cut out. And the color ink pad that I've actually used for this particular project, for this stamping circles, is the smoky gray. Okay, so it's not black, it's just gray. And the reason behind it is because I want my message to be in black, so I want my message to pop. Right, but I'm gonna show you obviously just the stamped effect first. And I do have a little bit of a stamping sponge underneath, and of course I am using a super smooth printer card, which is absolutely superb for stamping. Absolutely lovely. Okay, so this is the grey muted circle that you get. Beautiful. But I've already pre-prepared of course my circle so you can see it. And what I've done, I've cut out two of them. So basically, I'm just gonna layer up and lift my second part up slightly. So obviously I needed to cut out the middle of it. So I'm just leaving a tiny bit, I left a little tiny bit here to show you. And I'm just going to literally follow the pattern of my triangle. And my circle is done. Now, the last thing for this part is actually stamping my message. This message also comes with the circle bloom, so you've got everything in one pack. But the reason why I'm using this particular one is because this message fits inside of this circle perfectly. Right, so my message is stamped. And now I'm going to bring my second circle with the 3D pads on top of this one. So I also pre-cut my bloom flower die, and I've used our ionized two-sided pearl paper. So I absolutely love this color as well, because it just simply goes with any color that you have, you know, your pinks and aquas and, I mean, salmon, anything like that. It's just stunning. So we're just going to have obviously blue and silver version. Okay, so I've got three layers, four actually, but I think I might actually use three. And probably you saw me doing the pinching technique. All I do is just literally pinch my petals with my fingers so they do stand up. Okay, that's it. So my flower is done and I am ready to put everything together. So my tulle is obviously here. Okay, but before I will use the tulle, I will actually assemble my tags. So the tags are literally just for my background, just to give me a little bit of pattern. And now just a little bit of tulle. Now I am going to actually use my tulle like slightly roughed up in two places. Okay, and now we're just going to bring everything together. So my beautiful message is going to go next. Right, so I have my base down, so to speak, and now what I'm going to do, I'm going to take the silk vine and cut it up into a few smaller pieces. You probably noticed that on this card, I haven't actually used our natural fiber, but because I'm using this beautiful, very, very delicate product, I actually thought we will try it without it. Okay, so I'm going to just adjusting places. I'm also going to spray my mulberry paper flowers in blue, at least one, because I think I need a little bit more blue here. And then I'm just going to simply put everything together. Okay, so I'll see you in a sec. Right, so I'm nearly done. Okay, what I am going to do, first of all, I'm going to sprinkle a little bit of a crushed ice inside of my flower, big flower, where I do have my glue still wet and showing. So that way I have a bit of a sparkle, okay? And then finally, just finally, what I'd like to show you that using the same spray, Inca Gold spray, I'm actually going to add a little bit of color here and there. Okay, so now, obviously, you never know how the spray is going to react. So I'm going to give myself a little square, really. All I want is just a little bit of blue just here at the bottom. So shake your spray really, really well. And spray. Can you see what happens? Just that tiny, tiny amount of spray. It makes a huge difference because all the colors are now just really playing nicely together. So I'm just covering my blank card, and that's it. My card is done. Now, in fact, I could actually spray a little bit inside of my flower here, so that would be just the final thing, okay? But just a tiny, tiny amount. And then I will tell you the brand new little feature that we are introducing. There you go. And that's done. So my card is done. Okay, so as we are really at the end of this video tutorial, many of you always email us your wonderful comments, and many of you also leave wonderful testimonials on our website. But this year, we will try to print out as many or at least one per video, okay, and read it out, and also the person that we randomly select from all the wonderful comments and emails that we receive will receive the project of the day. So today, this lovely card that I've made, okay, will be going to a lovely customer called Elaine Bates. And she said, I have ordered from Anna Marie Designs a few times now, and every time my parcel arrives securely packaged and with a very gratefully received free gift. The dispatched time is excellent and the products themselves are lovely and beautifully packaged and very reasonably priced. I love the tutorials so that you can get the best out of your order. Thank you for the time and effort you put into your tutorials and the products you sell. I can, without reservation, recommend this company to anyone. Well, this is a wonderful email. Thank you so much, Elaine, and I hope you'll be very pleased receiving my card that I've just made, especially for you. Okay, so thank you very much for watching and stopping by, and hope to see you with our next tutorial. Bye-bye for now. Bye.